At the end of the last film, Queenie made a pretty shocking decision to cross over to Grindelwald's side, and that was done in a moment of extreme stress and a lot of very painful circumstances, one after the other. So it was a real quick-fire decision. And then at the beginning of this film, we find that she's been there for a bit of time, and the circumstances that she's in has sort of settled in, and we don't know what has happened to her, really. We don't know if she's still the Queenie that at least we thought we knew, or not, but we see her navigating some pretty scary situations. Like, this is a very different world than the one that she's used to. That's where we find her.
Yeah, he kind of reflects the times that he's living in, where when you last saw him, he loses Queenie, and he's still looking for her on the horizon. He's got that little glimmer of hope, and then when you see him at the beginning of this film, it's like he's just in an endless cycle of loss. He's like lost his appetite, he's lost his love, he's losing his bakery, it seems. It's like, and he's just in a state of depression, which is where, you know, we're leading into time-wise. And he's almost, you know, hallucinating about you know, the past, and then Lolly comes out of the blue and pulls him right back into it again, enticing him with you know, possibly getting back together with this one over here. His number one motive is to get Queenie back. He's almost given up on it and thrown in a towel when he's invited back into it again, and he's given a wand. So it's almost like, oh, all right, now he's a soldier, he's got a weapon, and he's got a team that he's part of, and he's got he might have a chance about, you know, getting back at least to see her again. And so yeah, it's all about getting back to Queenie.
David is such a lovely human being, and we've all been through, now this is the third film, we've been through a lot of life together, I've grown a lot on these films, and I really care about the films and have a lot of questions and want to really dig in to all the little bits in between in the scenes and make sure I understand what we're doing. And David really holds space for that, and had lots of conversations with me about things to make sure that we could navigate this sort of tricky transition. She's a very different character than when I started out, and it was hard to figure out how to maintain the essence of her, but in such different circumstances where she's so prevented from being who she was. I wouldn't have been able to do that without David. He was just right there with me. It was really good to know that he knows her so well as well. So we were all in it together.
It's always great to see this one. We become family friends. So we see each other.
Yeah, our families are
more often than the other folks. But it's always great to see Eddie. You know, he's awesome, and I got to work wonderful with Jude a little bit more in the last film. So that was awesome. It's always great to see him. And then, it's always great to, you know, three films now, everyone has become like family, everyone's friends. So it's always like a big reunion when we see each other. And And also, you know, all the new members have become fast family too.
Yeah. Also, we were filming during the height of the pandemic, and it was at a time when people just weren't seeing other people, and we were being tested constantly, and so we had the fortune of being in a situation where we could actually talk with friends and face to face in person and share that experience together. And Victoria Yates was also pregnant. Both of us were pregnant during the film, and we weren't able to go to any classes or do anything like that. So it was really nice to share that together. But I think just the fact that we were working despite such a crazy time, I think we all really valued that time when we could be together again and actually make this film happen.